What's up, YouTube? It's your boy in your window. If you don't get it, we in you win dough. But if you with it, when it's finished, in the end, you win dough, man. Let's go. Look, back at it like a bad. Another video for you guys. Let's smash. You could be checking out freaking new Eminem-Renaissance. The album came out. We're going to be reacting to each song individually, one by one. And then we'll check out the second bonus track that had came out at some point. I had some trouble reacting to the first one. YouTube tried to block my video, whatever the case is. But nevertheless, I'm going to be actually checking out this stuff. I know about any mom doing the full whatever the freak they want to do. But we're going to kind of break this down and stuff like that, see what's going on. Hope everyone's doing well, doing okay. And yeah, let's get it in. Eminem videos, I'm probably have a couple more of those up and rotate them around with other videos that I'm gonna be reacting and watching and stuff, because things are a little discombobulated and I haven't been able to record like I needed to, so I'm trying to get back into effect. But nevertheless, let's get into it. Oh my god, the spit, because that reminds me of, I'm pretty sure that happened on one of the clips that M posted on his Instagram, YouTube, and I probably posted on my YouTube as well. It was a video of him spitting on the Slim Shady Gray before the hand came up and stuff like that. So, yeah, that's kind of interesting, because he's like spitting on the grave, so to speak, of Slim Shady, like the disrespect, like good riddance kind of thing. So, yeah. Ooh, you can hear that. You can hear the freaking rain and the wind and everything. Yeah, that's definitely from that same clip. Experimental man, he stands rag, he's an experimental man, he stands pinning his hand like Edward Scissorhands, who slices competition and just goes about his business. Anyone who knows about, like Edward Scissorhands, he slices competition and then go about his business? Okay. Goes about his business. Anyone who knows about his shindig, shenanigans, and all his wacky antics in the papers. Shady's dangling, a baby tangled in a blanket, strangling him, hanging him over the railing by the ankles on some gangster shit. Child endangerment, dark brain arcane, but it marked. Ooh, and then the voice switch, like, is given, like, he's gonna be kind of rotating and switching voices and stuff, because I think, and then this is the thing too, because I feel like even in the Houdini video gave a lot of perspective of what the album is going to be about, which is why he dropped Houdini first out of all songs, because you got Slim Shady coming out the 2001 portal, I believe it was, and entering today's society and kind of say, like, how would Slim Shady react now? So I feel like it'd be kind of like a, and then even towards the point of them fighting back and forth for relevancy and who's going to actually take over. So does that kind of give a lot of perspective of what this album is probably going to end up being about. Like Slim Shady coming out, trying to do some cancelable things on the album. Like he was in that one video trying to cancel Eminem, trying to cancel Marshall Mathers. Like he kept going, doing different stuff. So I feel like that's going to happen kind of like at the beginning part of the album. And Eminem, Marshall's like the middleman. So Eminem's going to be trying to fight to like be like, no, I'm gonna handle this and you're no longer gonna cause trouble anymore. And that's kind of like where it's gonna conclude, because Eminem, Marshall Mathers, whenever he does his rapper persona stuff, it's normally Eminem. But Slim Shady is the more over dramatic character trying to do stuff without any filters. So trying to see how that's gonna go, especially when the point of them fusing together, so it's either like he's always gonna be a part of him or he got rid of him, so I'm trying to see how that's going to work. But I feel like Houdini had a lot of perspective of how this album's going to be about. But hearing the back and forth right here is kind of giving me an idea that that kind of was how the album was going to go, too. Yannick's in the papers, Shady's dangling, a baby tangled in a blanket, strangling him, hanging him over the railing by the ankles on some gangster shit. Child endangerment, dark brain arcane, but it marked Twain in it. You aren't taming it, sharp pain in the heart, aiming a bar chain, but it carved names in it. Start spraying it, start raving them beats, start craving it. You're at arm's length, you're in harm's way of it. About to show your ass why I'm still a pain in it. You wanna know how I do it? I can't explain the shit. Mechanics brain with a pinch of Big Daddy Kane in it. But I can show you the ropes till you get the hang of it. Show you the ropes till you get the hang of it. Rope, you hanging with it. Crazy. You the ropes till you get the hang of it. Elephantitis to the nuts element of intelligent hoodlum arrested development. Cellar dwellers and wise intelligence and element. To read through hell I went. Accelerant from lack of melanin. Filling in school smart eloquent. Help me to rebel again. Shit so well invent. So eloquently, yeah, I was irrelevant. Soon as I quit giving the fuck, I started a celibate. Now there's travel inside. Which is a double, him giving a fuck and then
not giving a fuck and celibate, like fucking celibate, but then also you get the point of like, as soon as he stopped caring about what people think and like did his own thing, it was like, all that, like, I'm gonna do what I need to do, killing it and going crazy or whatever, is when he kind of ended up in a position of like, okay, now I can have this I don't give a F attitude and see how that goes. And that's how he started to sell so much more versus his first approach in doing music and in the music industry and the songs and everything that he was coming out beforehand. So the, because Slim Shady was kind of like that introduction to this more aggressive side that he started out with, but his first album, his Infinite album, wasn't a Slim Shady persona. So that it just kind of says a lot that his Slim Shady persona is what made him start selling so much. Like, people gotta really think about that.
The mind of a hater, cause I don't see no fans, all I see travel inside the mind of a hater, cause I don't see no fans, all I see is a bunch of complainers. Kendrick's album was cool, but it didn't have any bangers. Wayne's album, a gaze, couldn't tell you which one was lamer. Joyner's album was corny, Shady's new shit is way worse.
Yeah, they do, and all that, people keep complaining about every little thing, and it's like, I get that. Sometimes, if it's okay or good critiques, then it'd be like, okay, that makes sense, like, X, Y, and Z and stuff, but sometimes people complain just to complain. It's like, you're either gonna listen or you're not gonna listen, and you'd be surprised how many times, I feel like every time I either post something about Eminem, I always get somebody that has to comment talking about somehow he hasn't been good for 20 years, Eminem stuff, like, all X, Y, and Z, all this crazy stuff, right? If you haven't listened to Eminem in X amount of time and you still think he sucks right now, why are you taking the time of the day to comment and being like, Eminem sucks, his music is corny, he's been trashed for X, Y, and Z? Like, you, okay, if you think about that, I don't go and listen and check and comment on every person's video that I don't like just to tell people I don't like them. I just like, oh, I don't like them, and then I leave it at that. Why do people gotta feel the need, especially for Eminem, to be like, he sucks? It's like, if he sucks, he sucks, but come on, like, you, if you really didn't like what you was listening to, you would take the time out to listen to it and continue to comment and make yourself known, like, you really care when you don't. Like, people be acting like, I don't care about Eminem. Yeah, you're literally doing stuff that you care. I don't listen to mumble rap, but you're not seeing me going on Tekashi 6ix9ine page every time he posts a video and be like, this music sucks, he's terrible. Bro, stop the madness, bro. Just stop the madness.
Joyner's album was corny, Shady's new shit is way worse. Everything is either too tame, it is too much anger. I didn't like the beat, so I hated, might delete later. You nerdy freaks would find something wrong with 36 chambers. It's what they do to the greats, pick apart a Picasso and make excuses to hate, so you can wait for your flowers until you're blue in the face. Stupid, you ain't gonna get them until your funeral, wait.
Oh my god, it's crazy, man, it's crazy. We're gonna pick it up with the next one being Habits. And we're gonna go straight down the list aside from these random tracks that's just popped up in the middle. I don't know what the freaks, whoever created this playlist is insane. But nevertheless, if you guys enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, baby. Share with your friends. I'm putting videos out every single week, pretty much every single day. Road to 1,000. Let's get it in. I appreciate you guys. Love you guys. I thank you guys so much, man. Subscribe if you're new. Go ahead and turn on post notifications. Be called the notification squad. And yeah, stay blessed and stressed. Good God, take a rest. See you guys in the next, man. Let me know down in the comment section below what you guys want to see next, what you thought about this song. I thought personally, super quick, this was an interesting introduction to the song because it kind of gives you an idea how it's supposed to go. I personally feel like I've listened to a lot of like first tracks of songs versus introductions that Eminem has done or whatever, and I like the Premonition song that he did on Music to Be Better By. I like that intro. That was like really like on point with how the album, so I like that. I really was messing with that. That's one of my favorite ones. This one is pretty good though too, to kind of give you an idea what's gonna be about. It's a 50-50 toss up. Like, I get the message and stuff, so it's nice just as a like intro thing or whatever. But I feel like it shouldn't have took a spot of a song. It should have been that going into a song as one whole track. But that's me personally. Other than that, see you guys in the next one, man. Peace, I love you, bye, and all that fun stuff. But yeah, catch you later.